It all started like 7 years ago in Israel. We tried to convert the internet style of communication into a high quality television format.
Only took 7 years. Yeah. Only took 7 years for us to catch on in America.
It's like 6 years before the selfie term was established. It has been sold to 22 territories and been in production in 12 territories by now, from India to Finland, all over. Yeah.
And what's the secret sauce? Why does it work so well?
Because it's what you can say organic and very authentic and
it's real life.
It's real life. It's not reality TV. It's real life.
The best part is we have incredible DNA that's been handed over to us from Israel and from the productions they've done. And what I told Ram the first time I saw it is there's things that you watch when you see them for the first time, you're like, God, I hate I didn't think of that. Like, it's such a good idea. And it's like, it's such a pure idea. It's such a beautiful idea. This whole idea of just like turning cameras over to people and letting them record their lives. And we live in a world now where that's what people do on a daily basis. We take pictures, we share videos. And now we're asking people to do the same thing with moments that are much more hard to share or hard to talk about or hard to, you know, kind of experience on your own. And the fact that they've had so many people who've been willing to do it, I think, is a testament to the power of the medium. And I think that now, as this is coming to New York, that we can do this here in the States is going to be, it's going to be powerful. It's going to be really life changing.
We were traveling all over the place with this format, and eventually, despite of the cultural differences, which is the differences, basically the conflict of human beings is the same, from India to Finland to Israel to the States, it's all over the same. And it's amazing that it's all the time about the relationship with their parents, about conflict, work versus career versus family. It's the same all over the world.
But Americans have much less of a problem taking their clothes off.
Yeah.
So I think that's probably what will happen in the United States. What Ram has done is like all these productions now are being done around the world, but all the post is happening with his core team in Tel Aviv, where these are guys who have been editing 3,000 plus hours of footage on every show that they've done. And so now we'll be shooting it here in New York City, sending it over to him, where his team will be crunching it down, sending us backstory notes to like give to the people in the field. And it's going to be a really beautiful organic process. And it's going to premiere January 2015.
Hopefully.
That's, hopefully. Yeah. Knock on wood. Yeah, knock on wood. Knock on wood. In about, you know, 8 months, we'll have a show. We'll have a show that's like going to blow people's minds on AOL.
Well, for me, as a raised and work in traditional television, it's very exciting to explore this kind of distribution, the new way of exploring the content. One of the reasons to do it with AOL is to be there with the new horizon that's coming with all this kind of distribution that we really don't know about, and we just try to be in that.
Yeah. And what I love, I like there's many things I love. One is the footprint that you can have. The amount of people that you can touch and have an influence on immediately is, it's not like thousands, it's millions. Like, the amount of people who can see this from the day we put it on air is huge. And ultimately, it's like, you know, when you start working with you know, shows where you can have much more of a larger stake in the IP, is like, this is his show. And so for him to be able to maintain ownership of a show that he created is a huge deal. And I think that's, as somebody who creates content, to be able to come into a situation where you can control the content and influence the content is a big deal.